A lot of people don't understand how rates work, especially what happens when properties are revalued. This video explains how it works. There are two reasons your rates go up. Either when council needs more budget to pay for the services it delivers, or when your property values go up. It's the value of your land that is used to calculate most of your annual rates bill. Think of council's income as a funding pie. Several sources of income represent the wedges of the pie. Rates is the biggest wedge, providing about 2/3 of our total income. Within that wedge, there are all sorts of rates, including those targeted to specific projects or schemes. A large part of your total rates is what we call the general rate. This is the one that changes with your property value. The process for setting rates is a bit complicated, so bear with me as I try to explain. First, we work out how much is needed to run the district. Then, we calculate the various fixed and targeted rates. Some are charged to all properties, while others are only charged to those properties that benefit from specific services or schemes. For example, if you are connected to a council water supply, you will have a targeted rate to pay for the scheme. Lastly, we calculate that general rate. This rate covers the cost of those services everyone in the district benefits from. Imagine there are only two properties in the district. The land value for both properties is $500,000. Both pay equal shares, or 50%, of the general rate. If council needed $200 under the general rate to run the district, each property would pay $100. Now, let's assume it's revaluation time, and property 1's land value stays the same, but the land value of property 2 increases to $750,000. Property 1's value is 40% of the total value of the district. The value of property 2 is 60%. Property 1's portion of the general rate drops, while property 2 has an increase. But council still needs $200 to run the district under the general rate. The amount needed hasn't changed, it's just split across the two properties proportionate to their land value. Property 1 now pays $80, or 40% of the total district value, and property 2 pays $120, or 60% of the total value. If land values increase, it doesn't necessarily mean an increase in rates, just that the percentage each ratepayer pays of the general rates changes. Let's go back to the pie. The size of the pie doesn't change. However, each ratepayer's slice may get bigger or smaller. So that's the basics of how our rates work. I hope this helps you understand a bit more. We know that some people may struggle to pay their rates because of COVID-19. If this is you, please do call our rates team. We have a few options that may be helpful to you. For now, thanks for listening and take care. Ngā mihi.